backlit silhouette, bow to you as fight or fly.
Thank you, all of you. Good evening, everybody, and my wife and I, Dorothy, and myself, I'm CTS. We are very happy to be up here in KL. We were just saying that we have not been up here for maybe at least 20 years. So it's a good opportunity to come up because now we have family up here in KL. We're also very pleased to have a son because we don't have any sons. When Dorothy and I got married, we planned to have a football team. But somehow, God didn't give us a football team. We only got one. And she's almost a football team. And we are very glad that she has found a husband that is a very, very good and capable man in Sydney. Very grateful for the family, and we discovered we do have some common heritage. My grandparents, and so, and Peranakan also. And so, a little bit of Peranakan, a little bit of Teochew. So we're very happy to be merging the two traditions and the two families. One thing we are very glad about is we don't have to lose power to Malaysia, because so many is working in Singapore. And they've just got a house close to ours on the MRT line, so we're very happy for this new couple, and we wish them all the best. And I think Jenny, we have brought them for one more thing. We brought him into marriage, now we brought them to do the next step, right? And lots of grandchildren for us. Yeah! So, thank you all for coming. Enjoy your dinner. And if you are coming down to Singapore, let us know, yeah? Thank you so much.
Hey, everybody. So, for those of you guys who know me well, especially the four tables who are my friends, I'd say family members tend to know me on a different level. But one thing I think that you guys might know of is that I don't usually like a lot of fuss. I don't normally enjoy big parties. So an event like this was something that was a little unusual for me, once in my lifetime. But I was asking myself this question because I think for those of you who are here tonight, you do know the challenges that our family is going through. And I think the question that popped in my head was, why are we celebrating? And I think for me, I had to find the answer to that question, not just because now I'm married, but to see everything that I've seen in the past few weeks, I think I found a lot of those answers. And I feel that going through those challenges, when I look at family members who are around, so many of you guys on the tables, coming and sharing the love and support and the care you have, not just for my father, but inadvertently to me and Paulin as well, and the rest of my family, I think that is worth celebrating. So grateful for both Mr. and Mrs. Toh, Dad and new mom, new dad, new mom, welcoming me into the family, but also to the country of Singapore. That is worth celebrating. So thank you so much for that. To all the neighbors, the family, friends, some have practically raised me, who've seen me go up from yay high. All that is worth celebrating, and I think a night like this especially, I'm so glad to see you guys here. For the families that my parents take care of, there's some of you at the back there, and I don't know if you're listening because you're a bit too far, but for those of you who have kids that my parents have taken, I just want you to know that it's not so much my parents taking care of your kids, but I think I've seen the love that your kids have shown to my parents as well. And again, that flows back to us as family members. And I do, again, think that is really worth celebrating. especially my friends, I joke that out of these 16, 17 tables, I got 4 tables of friends. It's not that I only have 4, but I do feel that you 4 are absolutely essential, simply because throughout our lives, some people I've known since I've been 7 years old, some people I've known again for more than 3 decades, all the way to newer friends, and so many more that I've met along the way. The not just love and support that you've shared with me through challenging times in this period, but any challenge in life, whether we were going through college, whether we were going through our own gaming challenges, whether we were going through work, any of those things, at any point that you guys as friends have shared some support, some words of care, that is worth celebrating. And with that said, that's why I really want to thank all of you guys for making tonight that much more special. And as you leave, whether it's tonight, whether it's tomorrow, next week, or the years to come, I hope that in any challenge in your life, you would remember perhaps a little bit of this speech, that there are things worth celebrating. Find that thing, and I hope that you carry it with you for the rest of your life. Thank you guys so much for coming.
Hi everyone, I'm Bowen. I know that this may be the first time for many of you seeing me. I do exist. thank you all for welcoming me into, I mean, I guess it's a part of your friends, your family. So Susan has thanked a lot of people, but he hasn't thanked my people. I would like to thank Susan's family. Simon's brother and sister have come all the way to be here with us at this you know, moment of a lifetime, hopefully only once, besides the one next week. That's the Singapore one, not a different one. thank you for being here for us, for him, during the important times of his life and being there for him growing up. Thank you, new dad, new mom. Thank you for bringing up such a wonderful human being. He's somebody who has a lot of love to give. He's very, he's so easy to get along with. He's so caring and considerate. You know, he doesn't always get things right, but he remembers every single time. And then I think that's what touches me, that he changes and he does things specifically for me that he didn't do before. Thank you for raising such a wonderful human being. It's clear that he's had a very healthy and loving family, and he's able to spread that love on to me and to my family. And thank you also to my parents. Thanks, Pa. Thanks, Mom. I think you did all right raising me. Thank you.
Yeah.